Hello, so I'm Mathieu Boutier still again, and it's very difficult to speak about after Julius Kramacek always, so I will try not to boring you too much. So I will speak about my implementation of UDP-based multipath application, which is multipath MOSH. So it's in the context of source-specific routing and so home multi-home network. So yesterday I explained that in a multi-home network, the host which has multiple IP address can select the outgoing path of this packet by selecting its source address. And conversely, the remote peer can select the incoming path of the packet by selecting the destination address of the host. So that allows to have new multipath transport application protocols. So at transport protocol, we have multipath TCP, which is just great, which works just great. And that's all, but the problem is that it keeps it simulates a flow as TCP, and so in particular, sometimes you want to be clever, you want to avoid retransmission because your application protocol can do things better. So you, and also multipath TCP will optimize this throughput. So if your application wants to optimize the delay or other metrics, you want to use another protocol, and especially over UDP. So it is possible to select the IP address with UDP at application layer with a send message system call. So I will not give the details, but you can ask me questions, but I will want to go directly to the MOSH part. So MOSH, it's SSH, which is better. So it's a lightweight interactive protocol, and the point is that you can continue to use MOSH even if when you change your place, if you unplug your Ethernet cable and you plug to your Wi-Fi, it will continue to work. You will not use your session. If you close your computer and take it to go to the office and you open it at the office, you keep your session. So it's a very elegant protocol. And it is also resilient to packet loss, so you didn't feel your SSH connection just typing one letter, and then you wait for the SSH to converge to have more letter. It's a very elegant protocol. However, in a multipath environment, it is not so perfect. First, it cannot distinguish the passes. So if you're using your 3G path, which has 300 millisecond of delay, and if you have a fiber path which is just perfect, MOSH will not be able to switch to the best path. And also, it cannot, wait, it uses just one socket, and it binds to one address of the remote peer. So if you are in a dual stack environment, IPv4 and IPv6, it will not be able to change to IPv6 because it is bound to an IPv4 address. And so finally, it will not use multiple paths simultaneously, of course, because it's a single path application. And so the point is that MOSH, as I say, is an interactive application. When you type something, you want to have a feedback immediately. So the metric to optimize is clearly the RTT, the latency. So what I do in multipath MOSH is that I will probe all different passes by sending little packets, and in order to measure the performance of each path, and then I will select one data path. So, okay, the concept is fine, but there is one problem. The RTT never decrease because you measure the RTT, but you can update the RTT only when you have a response. So if your link break, if your path is broken, you will keep that path which is which was considered as the best because your RTT never decreased. And so you must evaluate, you must define some timeout such that you will evaluate an idle time of the flow to select another path. And there is also a lot of other mechanism to deal with, like the server will delay acknowledgement, so it makes it more difficult to evaluate the transmission timeout and other stuff like this, which is complicated, but I can explain that offline. So the second point is that multipath is a lightweight application. And so at some point, someone tells me, okay, you are sending probes, which are little packets, but anyway, Moff is a lightweight application. Why aren't you just sending, duplicating all packets, each packet on all passes? And especially if the path you select has the best RTT but a high loss rate, it may be better to duplicate so that you will achieve a better reliability. But the idea of duplicating the data on all passes, well, it doesn't please to me, so I want something which is better because paying for nothing is not something that I like to do usually. And so what I do is that multipath Moff evaluates also the loss ratio of the path, and then it will select, it will duplicate only on some passes. So here is a basic idea of what it does. So it first sorts the flow by RTT, and then it will send the data packet on the third flow, so which has, in this example, 42% loss. And then, so there, it's a big loss ratio, so we will send a duplicate on the second flow, and we multiplicate the two values such that we have the expected loss ratio of the total sending, and so on, until we reach the 0% of loss ratio. And for the other path, we just send probes which are very very light. It's about 90 bytes. Okay, so as a conclusion, so multipath Moff is an application which has been designed in the context of source-specific routing and multi-home networks. And it uses lightweight probes to measure the RTT and the loss ratio and to be clever about duplicating just what you need to achieve reliability and performances. And now the question is, okay, that's good to do that in an application, but perhaps we didn't want to reinvent the wheel to each application. And so the question is finally, okay, we perhaps want to write a library or perhaps multiple libraries because the need of each application may be different. And to write a library, there is also more questions to answer, and especially when we duplicate the passes. Imagine that we are duplicating the passes and the bottleneck is on the same first part of the passes, then it was useless to duplicate, so it may be a good research project. And also, multipath Moff is a server is a clear client server application, and so we will think also what changed to appear to do a peer-to-peer application. Thank you for your attention.